This presentation may contain language and scenes which may be objectionable to certain individuals. Viewer discretion is advised.
All right, underdogs, it's time now once again for that sensational internet review show, Macho Movies. And I'm your host, everyone's favorite, Macho Mike. With today's movie starring real-life action hero, Rob Van Dam. Doing most of his own stunts, too. Protecting his family from a crime boss and his gang of killers. Who wants to die first? Wrong side of town.
The city is officially on lockdown.
You know this guy, Seth?
Mortis.
I trusted you!
He put $100,000 on my head.
Hello, sweetheart. My name is Seth. I'm a friend of your father's.
When my dad gets here, he's gonna kick your ass.
Who are you kidding, man? You don't know how to shoot that thing.
Just want a favor. We're even.
Let him go.
What?
All right. Who wants to die first?
What? What? You're sorry?
Proving once again he's the whole damn show, it's the whole damn show, Rob Van Dam. That poster sucks. Yeah, I really need to address that poster. So, Wrong Side of Town was a starring vehicle for Rob Van Dam, and RVD was very active online promoting the movie with his blogs and his videos direct from the set the entire time they were filming. And Rob was even assisting with some of the editing and production work, too. So why is Batista the one who gets top billing? Well, I'll tell you why. Writer-director Dave DeFalco, yeah, that demon guy there with the chain around his neck. Being a former pro wrestler himself, Demon Dave knew what he was getting into when he cast some ex-WWE superstars to be in Wrong Side of Town. And when this movie entered post-production in 2009, Batista went back to WWE and became world champion that year at Extreme Rules. Dave DeFalco decided to try and capitalize on that by centering the marketing around Batista. Needless to say, Rob Van Dam became Rob Van Mad when he found out like the rest of us did by seeing the new Batista poster online instead of the original that featured him. And Rob responded with a critical video, wondering if he was even still in the movie at all. And that was how Dave DeFalco lost RVD and any hope of Wrong Side of Town Part 2. So there you go. And Dave DeFalco learned the hard way that it doesn't make you bad losing to Rob Van Dam. It just makes you like everybody else.
Glad I could help you.
Well, now that we got that drama out of the way, let's talk about the actual movie. Now, Batista has gone on record saying that he was embarrassed by his acting in Wrong Side of Town. Personally, I thought he did okay here. But Batista decided to go out and hire an acting coach afterwards, and he obviously did something right, since you now see Batista in the Marvel Cinematic Universe with the Guardians of the Galaxy. As for RVD himself, well, honestly, he's not in his prime here with his acting either. But he's in great shape, and those martial arts are on point. I really like these fight scenes. They come across more realistic than most movie street fights. And you top it all off with Jerry Katz chewing the scenery of Seth, the main bad guy who both dresses and talks like he's in a comic book. You know, actually, there are a lot of characters here trying to act macho, but I got the macho mirror to show us what's truly macho about Wrong Side of Town. Right away, I'm going to point out two of my staples. Sunglasses at night, and those macho gloves that RVD wears. There's also a banging soundtrack. It's very diverse, from hip-hop to heavy metal. There's also Playpen Magazine, a karambit knife, avenging your family, overcoming the odds, a suit-up montage, self-first aid, and pick a hand. And we've got bullet to the head, spinning back fist, machine gunning, headbutting, hot wiring, vehicle chasing, ninjutsu, jujutsu, chainjutsu, and teejutsu, which you know is my personal favorite. Body count's 11. No women, though.
I am really not having a good night tonight.
Oh, and I want to take a minute to remind all you underdogs that you can follow me at my website, MachoMike.tv. I got more videos like this. I got macho merchandise that I designed myself up for sale that you can buy at MachoMike.tv. And there's also links to my social media, so you can like, follow, and subscribe. Check me out at MachoMike.tv.
Let me run it by the boss. I'll get back to you.
We love to.
Well, it may not be 420, but the clock on the dojo wall says it's the end of the video. Thanks for watching, underdogs. You've been great. I've been Macho Mike, and I'll catch you next time at MachoMike.tv. Till then, keep it macho.